Come back to our seats, and you can just sit down and gently close your eyes and take a deeper inhale and nice slow long exhale. And just gently closing your eyes, we'll start with a meditation, and I want to bring you on a really nice journey today, so let's just bless the journey. Just acknowledging where you are today, how you're feeling, how you are doing today. What's inside of you? What's been popping up in the recent days? What are the few feelings that you can notice? You could just name them for yourself. What kind of place am I today? And what we'll do today is I'll ask you some question, then I'll give a short time for an answer, sometimes a little bit longer, sometimes shorter. And you will just write, and we'll share, not after each question, but after a little while. So just the first question is, where am I today? Like, what is this place? How could I describe it? Where am I at this point in my life? If you need a little bit more in meditation, you stay in meditation. Maybe there's nothing really pops up, so you just stay in meditation. There's something that you know that you want to write down straight away. Where am I today? What is this place? How do I feel it? And what do I feel stuck with? That's going to be the first question. What is there that I would love to change? not how to change it, but what is that? So if I was asking you a question, what is there that you want to remove, get away from, or where do you feel stuck in your life at the moment? What would it be? How would you describe it? No solutions, nothing yet, just describing that. So describing that, it can be anything, something to do with job, with relationships, with hobbies, with a new habit, with anything. And describe some details for it. What is that place where you are today, where you feel a little bit stuck? And describe it for yourself. How does it feel there? How does it look like? Maybe it's just something that is stagnant. For example, I used to love experimenting with food a lot. And there were times when going all vegan or raw vegan would feel like exciting. And now eating vegan feels like just whatever. So sometimes there's excitement in those little things, and sometimes you feel maybe stuck with your diet, for example. So it can be anything, because it's going to be just a structure for journaling that you can use. And it's from a hero's journey that I'm using for my book as well. And when you have described that place, give some nice little details, and then you can just sit back in your meditation again. And when I say meditation, it's just nicely, comfortably, eyes closed. You kind of close yourself out from the outer world. Go a little bit inside of you and inquire, ask the questions within. And the next question is, let's make it like a really nicely spiritual. There's something that is calling you. That's why you want to leave that place. And what is that? How is that voice sounding? How is that? Is it something that you've been noticing lately that others are telling you? Or maybe you've read something in a book that wants you to move in a certain direction. It's like the universe is calling you all the time, reminding, maybe there are signs that you see all the time that you should start doing this one thing or something. What is that call? There might be a couple of signs. There might be signs every day. I see on some faces that there are many signs. So what is that call of maybe... And the hero's journey is called for the adventure, but what are those signs? And just write down the signs. So I've been getting these messages, or I've been receiving something from other people, or just in meditations, maybe something is popping up. What is that call for something? Thank you. And you can even write down the details that yesterday someone told me, then I saw on YouTube, then I heard about it on a podcast. And all the time there is this information, this call for what I should be doing. And when you have written down, you can again just sit back in your meditation. And we'll make it fun. How are you refusing this call? So there might be something that you know that's itching, that you should start doing this, and you see the signs, and how are you talking yourself out of this? How are you refusing to follow it? And this, be gentle with yourself, be like kind, and be just looking like a loving mother at yourself. And how are you refusing? How are you saying no to all these signs that you're kind of like turning your back on them? You're pretending that you don't hear that you're good enough for this particular role in your life, this new role that you could take. How are you refusing it? And write it in a fun way. So no hard feelings towards yourself, but just how you're refusing it. The offers that are coming in. And if you have nothing on your mind, you can even remember about some time that you did refuse like that. And just remind yourself of that occasion and how much effort you spent on refusing. And then later on, anyways, you went for something that was calling you. And then again, you'll sit back in the meditation. And just gently imagine you taking yourself and all these ways that you're refusing. Just like you would take a little kid and you just see one way how you're refusing and saying no to offers, no to things that maybe because you're a little bit afraid, it doesn't matter why. At the moment, we just know that you're refusing that call. You kind of know, but you're not moving that direction. Or maybe you already got over the refusal. The next chapter that you're going to write, and you're going to write for a little bit longer, and there are two approaches to it. Think about who is helping you or what is helping you to really, really go for this thing that you're longing for. Maybe there's a mentor, maybe there's a human being, or maybe there's a book or any other channel, like someone on YouTube you're listening to, an audio book, a podcast, someone who is guiding you. So one way is you can describe this guidance, this person who's guiding you, who's encouraging you, or if you don't have it yet, describe who would you listen to for the encouragement to go and continue on your path. So there can be two ways. If you have met already someone who's helping you with this call of adventure, you can describe that, and then if you don't have it yet, you can describe the mentor that you would love to have. Maybe you're looking for someone and you can just describe how this mentor could help you. What could happen if you had a mentor? And the mentor, it doesn't have to be alive. It can be a guru that has been working 1,000 years ago and you get some of his writings, or it can be an inspiring place, energetically charged. It can be anything. So give yourself the power of imagination. And at this place, let's share a little bit. Whatever you would love to share, you're welcome to share. Whatever you want to keep to yourself, you can keep to yourself. It's all good. Let's see. I'll unmute you all. You can unmute yourselves. And whoever would like to start and just share whatever you got and whatever came to your mind. It can be sometimes very different from what we journal about.
Okay, I can share.
Yeah, go for it, Christina.
Yeah. I got that I am at the new beginning. So it feels like something's happening and I don't know yet, and I feel stuck in creating.